today's class we are going to discuss about the apex beat. Before we know what is the apex beat, we need to know what is the precordium. Precordium is the anterior part of the chest wall overlying the heart, where we can feel a cardiac impulse. Where do we find a cardiac impulse? Over the precordium. The cardiac impulse is the movement of the anterior chest wall caused by the systole of the heart underlying it, and that is over an area, circular area of 2.5 cm diameter, where in which that area when we feel a definite cardiac impulse, which is the lowermost and the outermost, that is the inferior and the lateral movement due to the systole of the heart, is known as the definite cardiac impulse. So apex beat is the lowermost and the outermost definite cardiac impulse felt over the precordium, which we are going to now locate or localize upon a subject. Now we will be locating or localizing the position of the apex beat. We have already studied what is precordium and where we can find out the definite apical impulse is the point which is the apex beat. We will ask a normal subject to expose the upper half of the body, exposing the anterior chest wall, and make sure that he is comfortable. I would rub my hands and make my palm a little bit warm and place the base of my palm over the base of the heart with my fingers pointing towards the apex. While I place it over here, I can feel a definite cardiac impulse at a position round about here, which I am locating or localizing with the tip of my middle finger or with the tip of my forefinger. As I place it over here, I would also like to make sure, I can make sure by making a point of a cross with a pen. In case I cannot find the definite cardiac impulse over here or the apex beat over here, I will ask the subject to turn to the left lateral side, to bandhi ke bhule jaye, and try to locate so that the apex beat is more closely close towards the anterior chest wall and I can feel it and localize it. Again, if it is not even palpable over here, I will ask apni tuthe ushun, the subject to sit and lean forward, chuke jaye samne, and place my hand over here to locate the apex beat. Now again it is at the same position, shuyapa. So when I have placed and my finger on near the mark over here, now I have to corroborate with the normal position of the apex beat, which is usually 8 to 10 centimeters away or lateral to the mid sternal line and just inside the mid clavicular line or 1 centimeter medial to it over here. The common mistake made by students whenever they are asked to locate the apex beat, they start counting the intercostal spaces and locate the apex beat over here and then place their palm, which is totally wrong. First of all, you have to place your palm, locate the definite cardiac impulse, locate the apex beat, and then corroborate the position. In previous classes, you already know how to count the intercostal spaces, but we will go over it again. We know angle of Lewis is the space just below the manubrium sternum, which corroborates with the second rib, and following which is the second intercostal space. Then we go to the third rib, third intercostal space, fourth intercostal space, and fifth intercostal space. And by locating it here, we know that here the apex beat should lie. But beforehand, we have already located the apex beat and found it out here. In case we are unable to delineate the apex beat in either of the three postures, what do we do? We will follow the same steps on the right side. In case the subject may be dextrocardiac due to situs inversus, where will be the normal deviation in this position? In a child, this apex beat will be in the fourth intercostal space as compared to an adult, where usually it is found in the fifth intercostal space. Now that we have located the apex beat, we are going to know the reasons of impalpable apex beat. We have already seen that if the apex beat is impalpable on the left side, how we can locate it over the try to locate it over the right side in case the patient has dextroversion due to situs inversus. But there can be several other reasons to it, for which the apex beat cannot be palpable. What can be that? This can be due to the push out or the pull out effect. How? Lungs. We know the heart is located in between the lungs. If there is any kind of, on the left side, a pleural effusion or a pneumothorax, what will it do? It will push the heart from its normal position. Thus, the apex beat is bound to shift. Or else, on the other side, if there is, in the right lung, there is a fibrosis or any kind of lung collapse, what will it do? It will pull the mediastinum towards it. That will also cause shift of the mediastinum and resulting in shift of the apex beat. Number two, it can be due to the heart itself. If there is any cardiomegaly or there is a pericardial effusion, then what will happen? Then also the apex beat will shift. There can be mechanical causes to it also. For example, the subject is obese. In that case, it will be difficult to palpate the apex beat at its normal position. Or else the apex beat is located but just below the rib and it may appear to be impalpable. So these are the reasons for which there can be an impalpable apex beat. Following that, what is important for us to know is the nature of the apex beat. First of all, in a normal subject, we think that the character or the nature of the apex beat is bound to be normal. That is the definite cardiac impulse which we felt with the tip of the index finger or the tip of the middle finger will just touch it. But there is also a feeling of tapping apex. What is the tapping apex? For example, if the subject has mitral stenosis, then in that case there is a filling defect of the ventricles. So the ventricles are not getting adequately filled up, but there is the systole is taking place for which we can feel the apex beat tapping upon the pulp of my finger. There can be also forceful and ill-sustained character of the apex beat. That will happen due to volume overload. In which conditions there is volume overload? Aortic regurgitation, mitral regurgitation. So what is happening? There is the complete outflow is not happening. Thus, the ventricle is getting stretched. As a result of which, the apex beat is forceful, but it is ill-sustained. It is not lasting for a long time. Just opposite to it, there is forceful and well-sustained character of apex beat. That happens due to outflow obstruction due to pressure overload. In conditions like systemic hypertension, left ventricular hypertrophy, and there we get forceful apex, and not only forceful apex, there is also well-sustained apex beat which appears as heaving apex beat due to the pressure. So these are the characters of apex beat that are found. Now when you examine a subject, how will you report it to your examiner? You have to say, I have examined the apex beat of my subject which appears to be normal with a normal volume that I am feeling, and the character of the apex beat is also normal. Of course, you get the normal findings. So here is our comprehensive discussion over apex beat, and you can also read it in the notes that will be provided with this video. Thank you.